background information on the personnel side. Employees who are existing contractual commitments or new longevity increases, they will see pay increases in their salaries. In addition, as we discussed at the last week's meeting, police officers that start at a very low rate of pay, essentially at an apprentice level, $28,000 is the first year annual salary for new recruits, and then that gradually increases until they reach the base pay level for patrol officers, which by current contract is, I think, $52,252 a year. There are large deductions.
Yeah.
Excuse me? I didn't hear.
Why you spending so much on one area and cutting out another?
Can you continue, Bruce?
Yes. The police officers are due by contract step increases as they go through the first 3 years of their employment with the police department, raising their salaries from $28,000 gradually three measured steps to the base pay of veteran police officers, which is $52,000 a year. So you've got those four police officers that are here less than 4 years that are going to get step increases. The total of those step increases amounts to $39,000. That's a contractual requirement with the collective bargaining agreement you have with the police department.
Okay, thank you.
So those are the primary increases in the budget. Expenditure reductions, and obviously the folks that were here last week spoke out against the proposal to eliminate the animal control officer position. And I have proposed a reduction in next year's budget amounting to $36,537, which is approximately, not quite, 50% of what's cost for that position. Why did I leave any money in that budget? Because we anticipate that there will be transition costs, primarily unemployment, if Kathy is unable to secure a position elsewhere. So there are transition costs to ultimately phase funding out for that particular position. So the total cost for animal control, salary, benefits, and operating costs amounts to $75,523. Zoning and Building Administration, looking at the clerical function in the building and zoning, we felt that we were able to reduce that to from a full-time position to a half-time position. That's due to two factors. One is, one principal one, that is the consolidation of all our offices in this new building. So we have all of our departments, planning, zoning, public works, finance, clerks, all under one roof now. Previously, when we were segregated, this was the building inspection, zoning, town clerks, and tax assessor in this space right here. And then we had the 44 Southwest separated from this administrative office, and planning obviously in the Bates Motel just down the street. We consolidated, we're able to realize some efficiency in terms of use of personnel. One of them being that we used to have a phone reception in each of those offices. The zoning building clerk fulfilled that function for the space. Now we have obviously everybody on the roof, one roof. We don't need to do that anymore, and we cut that back to a half-time position. The savings to do so with a net positive revenue gain of $34,734 next year. In addition, we looked at staffing in the town clerk's office, and the existing staffing level is town clerk, deputy town clerk, and two part-time clerks. Two town part-time clerks provide 48 hours per week. We realized that we could convert those two part-time positions into a full-time job and save $10,840. Because it's only 37 and a half hours versus 48 hours of two part-time work consumed. So that amounts to a net savings in the budget of a little over $112,000 in spending reduction. I don't think I need to go through the revenue discussion we had last week, other than to say that due to state cutbacks over a town is experiencing a loss in state aid, amounting to $728,079. So almost $750,000 reduction in outside assistance to Jamestown. Most of that is in the motor vehicle tax, which we are proposing to reinstate in entirety, and that element will amount to $86.52 per car, if your car is worth at least $6,000.
Please hold your comments.
Thank you. So that is the overview of the budget, and the principal changes. But I think it's worthwhile to go through each individual department, that'll give the town council, particularly given the fact that a number of members are new and have not gone through a budget process before, an opportunity